Okay, well, we did not stay at my house because I think we were in a flood zone. But we went to my grandparents in Lynn Haven, and my granddad, he was still alive at the time last year. And they weren't in a flood zone, so we figured that was kind of the safest place to be at the time. And they live right near Walmart. And so, I mean, all I can remember is at the time, like, me and my dad, like, we like, watching like storms and stuff like that. I remember us like watching through the window, and we were looking at the neighbor's house, and there was this tree. It was just going like this, and I was like, "Dad, it's gonna fall. Like, it's going to fall." And it was a big tree. Like, that sucker was big. So the tree like completely fell over, and obviously like the whole yard was messed up. And after like the storm had passed, obviously everyone kind of went outside to like see what was going on. I remember it being like super cold because like it was super windy and everything. And for like I think maybe a week or two after that, my neighbor had a pool, and obviously like there was debris in there and everything. Well, we had a gas stove that still had gas like from before the storm, and it was fine. It got knocked over, but we picked it up and everything was fine. Well, we were like boiling the pool water in order for us like all get like baths. Like, we didn't get baths, but they got us through. And after they kind of cleared everyone to like start driving and stuff like that, we drove back to my house in Southport, and we had left one of our vehicles there. And y'all, all of my trees in my yard just were over. Like, there's no trees in my yard anymore. And our house is pretty much done for. And I remember a tree like fell on top of our dining room. So the ceiling was like this, like, because we didn't live in like a house, we lived in a trailer. And our ceiling was like this, and legally it was totaled or whatever. So we moved it. And we tried living in a camper for a while, but I mean, with like four people living in a camper that only has one bedroom, it's kind of iffy. So my dad, we had this pole barn before, so he kind of turned it into like our little tiny house, and we've been living in there for like about almost a year. Yeah, because the hurricane and everything. We've been living in there for a while. So there's two rooms, me and my sister, and then there's my parents' room, so it's like this. And yeah. So I guess that's kind of how my life's changed too. And we're building a house too. So that, I think that's a blessing out of all of it, is when FEMA came and they were, like helping people out and stuff. They helped my parents get like a low interest rate or whatever, so we were able to build a house. But it's taken almost a year for it to get started, but it's getting there.
You seem like a pretty positive person, and this is a lot of bad stuff that's happened and having to live. How do you maintain that?
Positivity.
I mean, it gets to me sometimes, especially like it's caused me to have a lot more patience. And it's caused me to be more grateful for everything that I have, because I know that there's still people out there that don't have as much as I have. And I mean, I just know that, I mean, I just know that God has a will, and no matter what, the good always comes out. That's how I just have to look at it.